Stone Mountain. This is a very unique masterpiece of nature that continues to amaze millions of people from around the world every year. The giant granite rock and the magnificent Confederate memorial carving, as well as the surrounding 3,200-acre park, are a place that the whole family can enjoy themselves just outside of Atlanta. Evidence of primitive settlements around the mountain were discovered by Lewis Larson, a professor at Georgia State College, who found ancient pieces of soapstone bowls and dishes linked to people living around this mountain nearly 5,000 years ago. Some of the curiosities of Stone Mountain are that there was once a wall made of loose fragmentary stone that encircled the top of the mountain. The wall was discovered by Reverend Francis R. Goulding on a visit in 1822. The purpose of that wall has never been explained. Historians believed it may have been used for ceremonial purposes, but the historic tribes in the area, the Creek and Cherokee Indian tribes, don't know who built the wall. They simply referred to the builders as the Old Ones. Native Americans farmed around this stone mountain and traded actively with the Spanish, British, and French for more than 200 years. The first European record of Stone Mountain dates to 1597 and the Spanish expedition led by Franciscan missionary Pedro de Cojos. A soldier in that party, Gaspar de Salas, was told by an Indian of a mountain about 60 miles away that was, quote, very high, shining when the sun set like a fire. This could be the earliest written reference to Stone Mountain. Some interesting legends tell of how Stone Mountain has changed hands. One legend is that John Beauchamp traded with Native Americans and acquired Stone Mountain for $40 and a pony. He later traded it to Andrew Johnson for a muzzle-loading gun and $20. In 1845, the Georgia Railroad was completed and the commercial potential of extracting granite from Stone Mountain became a reality. Stone Mountain granite has been used in construction projects throughout the world, including the locks of the Panama Canal, the U.S. Capitol Building, the Imperial Hotel in Tokyo, Japan, and the University of Havana in Cuba. Other structures utilizing Stone Mountain granite include hospitals, banks, courthouses, bridges, and more.
Well, Sue, we are standing on top of the world's largest exposed chunk of granite. And I gotta tell you, it's huge. The thing that amazed me, though, is all of the little ripples and depressions that are on top of this stone mountain here in Georgia. They're filled with water, water plants. There's actually little tadpoles in some of them. And over the billions of years that this has stood here, trees are growing out of some sections of it. There's all kinds of little plants that are growing right out of the rock. It's just amazing.
Even Doodles found a place to play on top of Stone Mountain. Needless to say, the view from top of Stone Mountain is nothing short of incredible. As it drew time for us to leave the mountain, we climbed aboard the Swiss-made cable car and headed for ground level. On our way to ground level, we saw the largest high-relief sculpture in the world, the Confederate Memorial carving depicting three heroes of the Civil War, Confederate President Jefferson Davis and Generals Robert E. Lee and Thomas J. Stonewall Jackson. The three-acre carved surface is larger than a football field. The carving itself towers 400 feet above the ground, measures 90 by 190 feet, and is recessed 42 feet into the mountain. The deepest point of the carving is at Lee's elbow, which is 12 feet into the mountain's surface. Plans for this began in 1912, but weren't fully realized until 1958, when the state of Georgia purchased the mountain and the surrounding land. The Georgia General Assembly created the Stone Mountain Memorial Association, and in 1960, the Stone Mountain Confederate Memorial Advisory Committee was comprised of six internationally known figures in the world of art. Work resumed in 1964, and a new technique utilizing thermojet torches was used to carve away the granite. Chief carver Roy Faulkner, a Marine veteran with a talent for using the new thermojet torch, was able to move tons of stone in each day. For over 8 years, park guests could see and hear the workmen and their jet torches. These figures, by the way, were completed with the detail of a fine painting. Eyebrows, fingers, buckles, and even strands of hair were fine carved with a small thermojet torch. The carving is much larger than it appears. Workers could easily stand on the horse's ear or inside the horse's mouth to escape a sudden shower. A dedication ceremony for the Confederate Memorial carving was held on May 9, 1970. Finishing touches to the masterpiece were finally completed in 1972.
This. I came here to see a big rock, so I'm going to try this one.
Well, it looks like Doodles made it higher than Sue did.
And of course, it wouldn't be a trip to the South without fried chicken, and lots of it. Check out this buffet.
So what do you have to eat, Kevin?
I had
Brunswick
stew,
good food,
fried chicken, chicken livers, barbecue, crab cakes, coleslaw, beans with hot peppers and vinegar. Man, this is living.
No wonder you burp.
And I'm going back for more.
Now you know Kevin's favorite part of any trip. I've got to teach him some Southern manners.
I apologize if I offended anyone, but it really was an unbelievable feast of Southern home cooking. We hope you've enjoyed today's program, and now you have a few things to see and do when you take your trip to Atlanta, Georgia. I'm Kevin.
And I'm Sue McCarthy, saying thank you for watching Worldwide Wanderings.